Are you frustrated having to mess with those pesky belts on your drill press every time you just want to change the speed? And it's so loud and annoying, makes you just want to lose your mind. Does your drill press have a light that does absolutely nothing? Have you ever spent hours searching for the reverse switch on your drill press to no avail? Well, no more.
I can't believe people fall for that shit. Everybody knows those infomercials are fake and totally over-exaggerated. Drill press with a treadmill motor. I wonder what this is all about.
This is the old tube for the drill press, and I've already swapped it out with this new, longer 48-inch piece to give me extra height so that I can easily move the table up and down and then have any length bits here and not worry about the size of the parts that we clamp into the vise.
That's giving probably pretty useful.
Versatility.
2.6 horsepower? What? That's crazy. 2.6 horsepower on a drill press? That's insane. Oh my gosh. Like, wow. You know what I could never figure out was like how they got the horses into the motors. Like, how do they make them small enough to get them in the motors? And then you don't have to feed them or nothing. I've never been able to figure that out. That's some just amazing feat of human engineering. What are they doing? What? No, 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 no. Oh my gosh. You're gonna ruin it. That is not how you take the flywheel off of a treadmill motor. That's insane. That's wrong. Yeah. It just reverses off. Reverse thread. Twist it off. Duh. What a bunch of knuckleheads. Really? Frick. Just go on YouTube and you can figure that out in like 2 seconds. Alright, looks like they are reducing the diameter of the shaft of the motor. Yeah, so they could probably reuse the pulleys. Did you see those sparks flying in your eyes there, man? Damn. That's dangerous. Yeah, it's probably a good idea to reduce the shaft of the motor so that you can reuse the pulleys. That's a good idea. Yeah, they're probably flat spotting the shaft here so that they can put the grub screw back on there and tighten it so it doesn't come off. That's pretty important. You don't want that. You don't want that pulley coming loose on that 2.6 horsepower motor. That's a lot of horses to keep track of. What are they doing here? What? That looks like the bottom of a seat, like an adjustable office chair or something like that. Oh, that's pretty good. I think they're recycling this office chair. Yeah, that's a great idea. That's a great way to make a bracket. It's already bent up and it's strong. Ooh, that's a great reuse and recycle. Yeah, look, they're cutting out the notch for where the motor's gonna go. Oh, that's pretty good. That's a pretty good reuse recycle item right there. That's great. Yeah. All right. Yeah. Drill out the holes. Probably this is where like the motor mount goes in the middle. Yep. Of course, you gotta do this before you dismantle the drill press. Yeah. Otherwise, you don't have a drill press to drill holes with. Now, there you go. Those are the holes for the bracket. Yeah. Decent. All right. This video is starting out a little bit better. Turning out to be a little bit better than the way it started with those knuckleheads trying to remove the thing with the... All right. Painted orange. Nice. Yeah. Why not? Painted orange. There you go. Couple of bolts. Screwed right onto the motor. That's excellent. Yeah, of course that makes sense. Now that you drilled the holes you need, you can disassemble the drill press. Sweet. Yeah. Man, you know, I have to write stuff down when I take stuff apart like this. Otherwise I can never remember how it goes back together. Yeah, just Man, I don't know how they do that without writing everything down. All right. Yeah, be safe right here. That spring is pretty wickedly tensioned there. Yep, that's a good idea to use that wrench. That's a good idea. All right, so they got the quill out. And they're taking that out. Yep, yep. Oh, tap that out. There's probably, yep, there's some bearings in there. Oh, cool. They're going to replace the bearings. That's probably a good idea if you're going to redo your drill press. Swap out the bearings and then hammer them off. Yeah, it doesn't matter if you destroy them. Actually, if Darth Vader was here, he could just use his lightsaber and just lightsaber those bearings off. That'd be a lot easier just using a puller here. Is he wearing an Overkill shirt? I freaking love that band. Freaking awesome. Yeah, that's the way to go right there. With that puller to get the bearings off. That's probably like the top bearing set right there. Double bearings. So it's probably a pretty decent drill press. Sweet. Sweet. Yeah. Just use whatever you got around. Whatever you got available. Nice. All right. So now they're putting it back together. Yeah, it's a good idea. Use a piece of wood and then a socket to press them on. So you press on the right side of the bearing race so that you don't mess up the bearings. Yeah, that's good. Oh, man. He's wearing a Motorhead shirt now. I freaking love that band, too. This guy's all right. All right. Yeah, use a socket. Tap those bearings in. There you go. There you go. Nice. Nice. So you don't ruin the bearings. Yeah, a little oil just because it's a press fit. Make them slide on just a little bit better. Nice. There you go. All right, that's probably the lock nut on the top of the quill. Probably reverse threaded on there. Yep. Yep, yep. You want to get that, yeah, tighten that down. That'll reduce all the play in the drill press quill so that you don't get any wobble or run out. Nice. There you go. That's good. Okay, what's he doing here? More oil. Oh, there you go. There's the top bearings. That's a double bearing. Yep. And then it's got a little clip, a ring clip, a retaining clip to hold that in. Nice. Then they slide the quill in from the bottom. Yep. Yep. And then there's the puller. And grease that up so that it works really good. There you go. And then the spring tensioner. Nice. Nice. There you go. That's how you do it. Now you put that motor with the new orange motor mount on the back. Yep, man, I still don't know how they get those horses in there. Dang, you don't have to feed them either. Don't have to water them or give them any hay or anything. It's a modern feat of engineering. All right, schematic, motor, 110 volt DC, speed controller, and bridge rectifier, and then goes to the double pull, double throw switch, and he's got a tachometer, 12 volt tachometer. Let's see how he wires this up. Yep, so a thermal switch in the motor, speed controller, goes to the bridge rectifier. Of course, his motor's 110 volt DC, yeah, so they gotta change the current, and then they just tap off the main line to get 12 volts for the tachometer. Then there's some sort of a plug and a light with a simple switch. Yeah, sweet. That's pretty straightforward. Yeah, that's really nice of them to include the schematic or the wiring diagram like that, because this is just a big spaghetti mess right here. Like, you know, how do I know what's wired to what? So that's really great of them to include that. That's really nice. That really helps out. So when you make one, you know how to wire it up. What is this? Little normal and reverse. Normal and reverse. What? Why is he painting it? Painting it? You can't see the letters. That's dumb. Why would you paint it? Little 3D printed part there. Don't paint it. What's he doing? Oh, that's brilliant. He's sanding off the tops of the letters so you can see it. Oh, that's a great idea. Oh, that's pretty clever. That's pretty clever. Yep, so they're wiring it up here back using the original housing. Nice. Nice. And there's the little tachometer there on the bottom. Oh, sweet. That's nice. That's nice. All right, painting the top cover. He's painting it outside. He probably doesn't have a spray booth. I'm a friggin' amateur, man. Doesn't have a spray booth to paint this stuff with. He needs a bigger spray booth, this guy does. At least he's doing outside and he's being careful, wearing a respirator and stuff. He probably didn't drill the hole big enough in the back for the motor, because the motor is a different size. You forgot to cut the hole out bigger for the motor. That's an easy mistake to make. That's funny. Yeah, that's, anybody can make that mistake. Yeah, just grind it out. That's good. That's good. Make it so it's not too sharp. What's he doing here? Oh, yeah, that's for the tachometer. It's probably like a hall sensor or something like that, so they can get the speed, the RPMs on the pulley. Probably going to be a magnet somewhere that they... There you go. Yep, look, there's the magnet, just super gluing it onto the bottom of that pulley. Nice, nice. So they'll be able to get accurate RPMs on this thing. That'll be pretty nice, actually. Yep, sure enough, look in the back there. That's why they had to grind it out there, so the pulley fits in the back. What's he drilling out now? What the heck? Of course, he couldn't use a drill press because it wasn't put together yet, so he had to do it by hand. Yeah, that sucks. All right, let's see, a spring. What does he need a spring for? What is that part? That's weird. What that is. What the? Oh, yes. He's got a little belt tensioner going. Yes, so the belt doesn't flop around as much. Oh, that's pretty clever. That's real smart. Yeah, you can reduce the noise that way a little bit. Yeah, you put the knob back on. Really, you just painted it black? You didn't make a new knob or nothing? Lame. Cool, put some stickers on there, yes. Yeah, advertise for yourself. Forget advertising for somebody else. Advertise for yourself. Good for you, buddy. All right, there you go. Put that drill press back up there. Oh, it's my favorite part when you pull the little plastic off the new gizmo. Yes. All right. Oh, nice. Look at that tachometer. That is sweet. That's way easier than adjusting the pesky belts. All right, I'll take that back. This is pretty cool. If you can just adjust the reverse. Oh my gosh, yeah, that is pretty sweet. That's pretty freaking nice. Yeah, nice light so you can see what you're doing. Excellent. Nice. There's that little pigtail. I wonder what the heck that's for. Oh, and you can just plug something in. It's extra power. All right, he's using a light here for the front. Oh, decent. All right, that's pretty sweet. Oh, he can mill. You can mill with this drill press. Oh, yes. Nice. Oh my gosh, I wish I could mill on my drill press. That's pretty nice. That's a pretty nice thing to have. All right, this video is pretty cool. I like it. All right, thumbs up. I'm gonna subscribe, and then I'm gonna hit notifications too, so that I get notified whenever this guy's got new videos. I bet you this guy does some pretty cool stuff. That's pretty sweet. Oh, he's on Instagram and Twitter. Oh, I gotta check that shit out. Yeah, I gotta follow him there too. Nice, pretty cool. Oh, look at this. He's got a bunch of other videos too. Awesome. Rock on, dude. Awesome build, man. Well done.